My name is Ethan Candyfire. I'm Kiowa Apache and Cheyenne Arapaho. I graduated from the American Indian Studies program. I made this mural, and it's about contemporary identities. That's the name of it. And it's about our relation to the land through traditional stories.
We're at Haskell Indian Nations University. And what are we doing today?
Right now I'm painting some of my heroes. I got fellow Haskell scholar, Stephen Paul Judd. There over there is Vine Deloria. Nicole Hatfield. Very strong and like empowering youth and women. Like, her work is dope. It's got Momaday. It's like all his work is identity based, you know, and just those stories and keeping it and, you know, sharing it and expressing who you are. The people that are on there, they're my personal heroes. I'm just so blessed that I got to paint them. In my first mural was Vine Deloria, and he's like the grandfather of education. You know, you don't graduate from Haskell without reading some of his work, and I'm using their experiences as motivators to say, all right, this is why my education is important. Stephen Paul Judd, he takes like pop art, the heroes, the mainstream culture, and he puts like a native slant on it. And I think the work he's doing is really gonna capture the attention of our youth. As a kid, when we imagine like heroes, we imagine ourselves as those people. And that's how we learn how to take pride in ourselves and how we build self-esteem and confidence. That part of him is like super inspiring to me. We talk a lot about what is traditional. Each one of them can really articulate that. And understanding that we have to adapt. We're modern, you know, we're living in modern times. All of them have done in a sense. And it all ties to education. The landscape is basically just who we are, how we relate through it, through these traditional stories, how our cultures are really holistic and a part of us. And it's not that we own the land, it's like we are the land. The land really owns us. One of my favorite quotes that Momaday ever said, anything's bearable. You can make a story out of it. And for me, that's powerful. And passing stories down to my children is super important. You know, I tell my daughter trickster stories all the time. Trickster, for a lot of tribes, he's our hero. He's not necessarily a good guy or a bad guy. He possesses both good and evil. The trickster is a teacher. We learn morals by his example. It's about expression. Like, the thing that I wanted to promote is that those are all scholars, and they all have an experience, and they all relate to the world in some way. They're successful in two different worlds, in a sense. To be able to share a story, to be able to have a positive effect. And the whole point is like, those stories, they're not in the past. They're still a part of us today.